Wer Tony Williams am Schlagzeug erlebt, der sieht sich einer Naturgewalt gegenüber. Scheinbar unerklärlichen Ausbrüchen von Rhythmik, Dynamik und Präzision. Tony Williams begann seine Karriere als 17-Jähriger im heute legendären Quintett von Miles Davis. Und seit er die Szene betrat, ist er eigentlich unnachahmlich geblieben. Seine aktuelle Gruppe umfasst Bill Pierce am Saxophon, Wallace Roney Trompete, Mulgrew Miller am Klavier und Bob Hurst am Bass. Das Tony Williams Quintett.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the band, because there have been various musicians performing this week at the festival, one of whom was McCoy Tyner, and I asked him about other pianists, up-and-coming pianists, that he particularly enjoyed, and he said straight away, Mulgrew Miller is a great piano player. So perhaps we could start by talking a bit about him.
Okay, let's do that. Let's start. He's a great piano player. When I put the band together in 86, he was the first person that whose name came up. So he makes the whole band really sing. You know, he's the best young keyboard player, I think, in the world right now.
Backstage, too, there were various other musicians listening to what was going on, and they all seemed very, very impressed by Bob Hurst, the bass player.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He's great. I mean, the whole band for me is a joy to play with, because it's hard to find people to play with, especially bass players, you know, for me anyway. The bass is the closest instrument to the drums, physically and musically. So to find a bass player who I can work with is a godsend for me. So Bob has really made the band a lot smoother than it was. Sorry if I'm still perspiring here from playing, but it's a lot of work up there. And the TV lights are very hot, so I'm still perspiring.
Okay, we should make it brief, but I think in fairness, we should mention everybody in the band, of course.
Yeah, there's Wallace Roney on trumpet, and Billy Pierce on saxophone. They've been with the band, everybody's been with the band since 86, except for Bob Hurst, the bass player. He just started about a year ago. So, and we've made, let's see, 3 albums, all on Blue Note Records, Foreign Intrigue, Civilization, and Angel Street. And we're getting ready to make the 4th. I don't know the title of that yet, though.
I'm not sure this is a naive question, but I'll ask it anyway. I mean, have you ever considered performing solo as a drummer?
Yes, I have. I have done that, actually. I did a solo piece in Brazil last November. Or was it October? Well, last year, anyway, somewhere at the end of last year. It's fun. Thanks for asking.
Well, I think it's interesting to know that. I mean, what was your feeling? What was the experience of that, being out there on your own without the support of the other musicians?
It was great. I mean, I loved it. I've always wanted to do that, you know. It's just the drums, and the drums have a lot to say. You know, I've always felt that the drums are as passionate and can be played as tenderly as any instrument, as romantic as, say, a violin. It just takes the right setting to do it and to be able to express those feelings.
Though traveling, you get the opportunity to hear music coming from other cultures. I mean, what particularly has influenced you, for instance, in the last few years, other countries?
Other countries, I can't really comment on that. You know, I stay home a lot. When I'm not working, I'm at home in my living room, or, you know, I listen to a lot of music, but I can't really say that a music from another country has. I mean, in the years in the past, when I was a teenager or in my early 20s, I used to listen to a lot of Middle Eastern music. And but lately, I've been listening to news radio, watching the stock market.
I'm not sure if I should ask if that's had an influence on your music or not.
No, it hasn't. No, it's just a hobby. It's a hobby of mine. I have a lot of hobbies.
That presumably wasn't always the case. I presume there was a time in your life when jazz was really the central point of your life. Has that changed a lot over recent years?
No, music is the center point of my life, yeah. I mean, no, I don't think so. I think that's always been the way it has been with me. You know, I've always been interested in, you know, nice-looking lamps, comfortable sofas, you know, the way things look. You know, I like flowers. I've always been that way.
I thought for a minute you were going to say nice-looking women.
Always. Always.
Tony Williams, thanks very much.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Thank you.